Today we're going to do an oxy-acetylene setup and then the first cutting project using the cross-cut method. So first, your gloves need to be free of grease and dirt. Remove your gloves. Put them somewhere that you're not going to trip over them. Make sure your bottles are strapped in safely. They're not going to fall over. First thing you want to do before putting your regulator on is blow out any debris that might be in the opening. Okay, so don't stand right in front of it, stand up ahead of it, and just a quick open and shut. Okay, same with the acetylene, open and shut. Okay, and start with one regulator at a time since they're expensive. Acetylene is left hand thread. Try to maintain your regulators facing straight up and down. That way they're easier to read. Next, you're going to tighten them with an inch and an eighth wrench. Your acetylene left hand thread. Oxygen right hand. You want to make sure that your adjustment screws are backed off and loose before you crack the bottles. You're also going to want to crack the oxygen very slow at the beginning and do not stand in front of this gauge. It could explode. Okay, and then you want to open it all the way. Acetylene also starts slowly and you only want 1.5 turns. Now, wrap your cord, hoses. And we're going to want to set our oxy and acetylene for what we're cutting. So today we're going to be cutting 3/8 plate. Okay? So we'll aim starting at approximately 3 psi acetylene, 30 oxygen. So now we're going to screw this in until it starts to register. Okay. 3 psi. Oxygen, I'm going to turn up to 30. Okay, I'm not done setting my regulators yet. Now I have to balance the torch. So you want to turn on your acetylene, which comes in the red hose and has the notched neck. Turn it on slightly. Okay. Now we want to take it out of this, there's your smoke. You want to take it just out of your smoke ring. Make sure your helmet's set on 5 or your glasses are on 5. Now we want to start introducing oxygen. Slowly. Make sure this bottom valve is open first, all the way. Your adjustment valve is up here on the torch. Now you want to introduce oxygen slowly. So now we have to balance our torch since it just blew up. So my oxygen's off, my acetylene is now off. Turn the acetylene back on. And I'm going to turn it up. Just enough so that it's out of the smoke range, but it's not a vicious cross-cut method. With your cross-cut method, you're going to hold your torch as if you were a camera's tripod. So one hand under the other. I have small hands, and if I don't have something higher to rest on in order to keep my torch level, I need to ball my hand up in a fist. But you want to use that hand so that it's a pivot point, okay? You want to have a good body position so that as you go to cut, you're stable, your hand's stable, your torch is stable and smooth, okay? First thing you're going to do is you're going to mark your plate every half inch using your combination square. And then you're going to draw the lines every half inch using your combination square. So I have one already completely marked out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set it at a comfortable distance from me. I can stand straight up and down, and my torch is right there, right where that line is, without having to lean or reach. I'm also going to clean my tip because it is dirty. In order to clean your tip, you need a tip cleaner and you want to have a slight flow of oxygen on. You want to go in and out once of every orifice. Proper sized wire. Otherwise, you ring the hole out and it will cut.